I'm Styleboy and welcome to my world, and today we are taking a moment of appreciation. This is a very random video, I do know. I've been working a lot with uni work. Like, I've been doing so much recently. Like, I'm on. It's a busy period. I felt stressed. I'm not gonna deny.
What was that noise?
So, what I kind of did on my lesson on Wednesday after a wild day, I became lecturer for the day. It was a half day, so basically I've decided to kind of just like take a walk around a little bit of Central, Hyde Park, and I kind of just stopped and I was looking at everything, really just like appreciating. That's my favorite way of my self-care, is just stopping and appreciating life. And I remember I had a conversation and it just made me go like, wow, I'm very grateful for a lot of things in my life. So in today's video, I thought we'd just take a moment of appreciation for life. This is very random, I do understand, just roll with me here. Rolling on a river. Some are like deep and some are just random. Like, some are so random, but that's, I feel like that's the point of appreciation, to have like a mix. As Hannah Montana said, the best of both worlds. And obviously before we start, if you haven't, go and subscribe, join the community we've got here. It's a fun time. And without further ado, let us begin. So the first one, which I definitely have thought about a lot and does come into my mind quite a bit because, I'm quite introspective like that. Well, like, is my growth as like a human being, and particularly from 15 onwards. Now, you can actually see my growth, especially on my YouTube channel, because I actually made my first video when I was 15. That was a moment. I don't know if it was the moment we needed, but she did the damn thing. And you can really see how much I've grown and developed as a human being, especially from like then to now. And you go through all my content and you can really see everything. And I just kind of sit there and I'm like, wow. I think not only would 15-year-old me would be proud, but also child me would be proud in many ways, because I think I've grown to be the man that I think I've always wanted to be. And like, granted, I still have some growth to do and I'm completely cool with that, but like, I just sit there and I'm like, I'm very proud, and I'm so proud of that. I think particularly within like my autism, whatever, like there was a period where I felt like, oh my god, it was like only a bad thing, that it wasn't good. That's not the case, sweetie. Like, your autism is such a big part of you, and while there are moments that are just like, they're not the best, there are things that you should appreciate about it, because without autism, I would not be me. But also like my acceptance of my sexuality, and yet like all of that stuff, and kind of going after what I've been like just wanting to do. I think that's something I really, really do appreciate within myself. Like, that was a cute little one. Second one, because the t-shirt says anything, the Animal Crossing update, the DLC. Do you know how great it is? Oh my god, I've been having so much fun. It's like, after like all my work, I'll just play it and I'm just like in utter bliss. Although the DLC is very addictive. Oh my god, like once you start, it feels like you can never stop. And I've also restarted my island. So we're kind of going for like Gilmore Girls energy. How much like joy it gives me. I feel like to be appreciative of the joys in your life is very important. So number three, my work. And I mean my work within every single aspect of my, not only my channel, but also like my work ethic and my work as in like my uni work. I think especially because I've started to post again on my second account, which is more like my art professional kind of account. I love the work I've produced. And I think especially going through it and kind of like organizing it and being like, okay, what do I want to show? What don't I want to show? And for portfolio work, I think it's so incredible just to kind of like look at your work and be like, wow, I'm proud of it. And it makes me more excited for the work I want to produce, because I feel like it's only going to get better from here. And I feel like you can definitely see my growth within my work. So I'm very, very, very proud. And I feel like I'm proud of myself. Pat on the back. What else am I grateful for? Oh, Taylor Swift Red, Taylor's version. The 10-minute All Too Well. The All Too Well short film. Bitch. It's incredible. I love the way it's filmed, because it's filmed on like a 35mm camera and it looks so beautiful. It's great. And the scene, you know, the scene where it was like after the dinner party. Oh my god, that's incredible. I can't believe that was improvised.
Such bullshit. That's such bullshit.
You dropped my fucking hand. What am I supposed to do with that?
I didn't even fucking notice. What are you talking
about?
I don't know any of these people.
They're all strangers. They're all older than me.
But like, what are you talking
about? I feel so out of place. You're the only one
that
makes
this about you.
You won't even look at me.
You are telling me that's improvised? Bitch, I am not over it. On the theme of music, I'm also grateful for little mixes between us album because do you know how good those 5 songs are? Trash. If you've watched my Little Mix video, you already know that I love Trash, but come on. Trash is a bop. Cut You Off is a bop. Between Us is beautiful. And No with a video. The video is giving me everything in life. Now this one, I'm very, very grateful for, which is my friends and family. There are moments where I just sit there and I'm like, I'm so grateful because friends is always something I've struggled with. And I still sometimes struggle with friendships and kind of like navigating them and whatever. I think everyone goes through it, but especially being autistic, it's like because I'm not able to sometimes read different things, like tones kind of rush over my head, or even that, like, I don't know, my insecurities of like I'm being too much, and I do this because I'm not, but like I am too much for people when I just literally just want to chat to them. I think I'm starting to get a good group of friends. I'm starting to really like hone in on that, and I think it's something that I'm very grateful for. I'm meeting people and I'm enjoying that, and I think that's something I'm really just grateful for at the moment. And also my family, because I feel like I'm very privileged, especially being a, like, being gay and autistic, that my family do accept me and do love me for who I am and are also willing to learn. I feel like that's something that I am so grateful for. I know that's not the circumstance for everyone, and it is sad that you have some people who can't actually be out or be open with their family or in the world. So it is sad, and it's homophobia. If you're not able to be out to your family or anything, or you don't have a great relationship with your family, I hope you have people in your life that you just appreciate and love, whether it is literally just like your best friend, anyone. I hope you have someone you are able to be grateful for in that sense. Oh my god, I just went very deep. The next one, okay, I love how we went from deep to like this, but I don't care because I have loved this series. So if you did not know, I'm basically trying to watch as many films as possible this year. I've now got up to 42 films and series. I'm impressed, and I have some more to watch this year. I ended up watching the Tinkerbell series, and I've never seen it before. You're probably on the next step. You're a Disney kid. How have you never? I know. But let me just say that series is a masterpiece. There are some I would personally skip. Like, I prefer the second half versus the first half. The first three, apart from number one, I love number one. Two is meh. Three is... that little girl's annoying. 4 is great, 5 is fantastic, and 6 is the best. I love the series. It made me just want to become a fairy. If you're asking what kind of fairy I would be, I feel like I'd either be like a winter fairy, a flower fairy, or a light fairy like Iridesa. But my favorite fairy is Silverdrop. She's so cute! I love it. It's very like a comfort series now. Like, I think if you ever were in like need for like comfort, that. What else am I grateful for? Wanting more out of life. Very random, but like, that sounds very weird and kind of like defeats the purpose of this, because you're supposed to be grateful for what you have. And I'm like, of course I am. Like, I'm grateful for like the bed I have, where I am in life at the moment, but I'm also grateful that I do want more out of it. Like, I want to travel, I want to explore life, I want to live in different cities for a bit, I want to just try different things out, and I'm so grateful that I do have that yearning and that drive to do so, because I feel like there's so much in life to explore, and if we just stick to one thing constantly and don't do what we want to do in life because of so many different things, of course within reason, I have that drive, and I feel like that for me is something that I absolutely adore and I'm so grateful to have, and I'm so excited when it becomes more safe and we are able to travel more. I feel like the first place I'm going to travel to is Barcelona, either there or Paris, just so I can go to Disneyland Paris and get the Disney ears. I just thought literally the most sweetest thing also that I guess grateful for and appreciative for, and something that I enjoy. I love seeing my friends succeed, and I feel like when you hear your friends succeed or do good things, oh my god, it makes me so happy. One of my friends is having a great time with a guy, so eek! And another friend has got a job as a videographer, so yes, bitch! Oh my god, I am so happy for them, and I'm so happy for like everyone when they do good things, because it's like, it makes you smile. And for me, I appreciate that a lot, and I'm so grateful for that, because it's just like, you see your friends and people you care about succeed in life and do things that they want to. Not only like within like monetary or like career-wise, but also within life in general. Like, for me, one of the most proudest moments, I kind of feel like when a friend who hates their job goes, I quit, I'm like, I always go congratulations, because especially if they hate it or they're done with it, do you know how liberating it feels to leave a situation which is not good for your mental health and not good for you and anything like that? It's so freeing. And I feel like for me, I feel like that is something I'm very grateful for, to see them succeed. It makes me happy and it makes me joyous. And I'm also grateful for Christmas. Actually, I'm not religious at all, but I love Christmas. I love the lights, I love the colors, I love the movies, I love the presents. Who doesn't love the presents? I love just everything about it, and I love the season of Christmas. December is Christmas, I don't care. So you have the whole of December, then you have that like that in-between period, which is between Christmas and New Year's, which often means Boxing Day sales. Oh, we love a bit of shopping. And then you have like New Year's and like making down goals, and then straight after that is my birthday, which I'll be turning 22, so yes, I do expect you all to be playing Taylor Swift 22, Taylor's version, at the top volume, and I will be dancing to it all night long. I am so excited for Christmas this year, and I feel like, I don't know why I'm more excited for it than other years, but I think it's probably because now we're out the house. We can go and like explore the cities and go and see people, and that's another thing actually that I'm grateful for. This year round, like, we're not on a lockdown. I'm so grateful for that, because lockdown was a mess. If you know me, I really like suffered mentally through that whole period. So for me now to be experiencing the emotional clarity and a lot more enjoyment, I would say, as particularly within going out. And maybe that's like the extroverted tendency in me, but like I love just to go out and just like to just wander around a city and just do something like that. Not being in lockdown made me grateful for all those little things. Like, I know the little things that we take for granted every single day. I don't know. That's why I love doing my like self-care dates. Like, I love just like doing something that I want to do, like whether it is going to a museum, shopping, doing things for myself basically. I love just taking care of myself, and one of those ways of taking care of myself is to go out and just experience the world by myself and take my time and just enjoy it and get excited about it. Life is very weird, but I look at that Ferris Bueller quote, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. And that is something I think I've definitely realized. I don't know about others, but for me, it's just this point in life where I kind of want to stop and just appreciate it, because there's many times that I feel like life just literally zooms past and just goes so quickly, and it can be very overwhelming. So for me, just a day just to stop and just take in everything and enjoy life a little bit. I'm grateful for everyone who subscribed. Thank you. I'm so grateful, because I think especially within the content I make now, with autism content and queer content and music content, it's like I feel like I really am able to connect with you all. And that's something that's so exciting and so fun. So I'm just so grateful for you all. So thank you so much for those who watch, who comment, for those who just want to chat about the themes and the video. Like, it means so much. So thank you so much for like taking your time to just watch this video. It means so much to me and it makes me feel good. So thank you so much. I think the last thing I'm gonna say is I'm grateful for me. I'm grateful for who I am, and I'm grateful especially how much I've learned. I know I said that at the beginning, but like I feel like now I definitely know so much more than when I was younger. Like, I think the best example is workload. Like, I'm so grateful that I can now learn, like, you need time off, you need to break, you need to get out of this room or whatever. Like, it is okay. And I feel like that for me is such a mind-blowing thing. For others it's like, oh my god, it's nothing. But for me, that's so mind-blowing, and I feel like I'm so grateful for coming to that realization. It makes me very, very happy. I feel like that is the end of the video. I'm just grateful for a lot of things in life, and I feel like this is quite a good thing to do, especially if you feel like you're currently like very stressed, or you feel like there's a lot on top of you. This isn't used to invalidate your struggles either. I don't want this to, because I'm still like dealing with so much work. It's supposed to just encourage you to maybe just stop, breathe, maybe take a little bit of a break, and just kind of look around you and be like, I know work isn't great, but there are some good things happening, and I appreciate that. That is the end of the video with the shoulder rolls. I do hope you enjoy this, and I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I shall see you guys next week with the next video. Bye.